international sex symbols, beloved sitcom dads, and soap opera patriarchs. What did they have in common? They all appeared on the original Charlie's Angels. These are some of the show's stars who are no longer with us. Farrah Fawcett lasted only one season playing Jill Monroe on Charlie's Angels, yet she still remains the face of the series. The Corpus Christi, Texas native, who got into showbiz via modeling and TV commercials, was still an upstart when cast in the series. It helped that she was married to TV icon Lee Majors, even nabbing a few cameos in his hit series, The $6 Million Man. But from the first Angels episode, her fame quickly eclipsed that of her husband, thanks to a wavy mane that turned her into a mini industry.
I don't think about being sexy a great deal, so when somebody says that about me, I kind of go like that.
But she quickly became hip to the pandemonium. The Guardian quoted her as saying of the show's ratings, "When the show was number 3, I figured it was our acting. When it got to be number 1, I decided it could only be because none of us wears a bra." Fawcett's decision to leave the show in 1977 sparked a lawsuit from producers, until she agreed to appear in a few cameos. A few years later, she left Majors for an on-again, off-again relationship with actor Ryan O'Neill. After landing parts in movie disasters like Sunburn and Saturn III, her career took a nosedive, until she received some validation as an actor in more serious outings like The Burning Bed and Small Sacrifices. Her lengthy bout with cancer put her in the headlines once more, capped by her death at age 62 in 2009. John Forsythe almost appeared in every episode of Charlie's Angels, but he had the easy part, supplying the voice of detective agency boss Charles Townsend. According to Jack Condon and David Hofstede's Charlie's Angels casebook, his relationship with the show started when producer Aaron Spelling called him for help. Forsythe said, "I didn't even take my pajamas off. I just put on my top coat and drove over to Fox. When it was finished, Aaron said, 'That's perfect.' And I went home and went back to bed." Forsythe was far more visible as oil baron Blake Carrington in Dynasty, a soapy drama series that ran for 9 seasons starting in 1981. His stoic figure and weather-beaten voice made him an ideal choice to play power-oriented characters, from a CIA operative in the movie Topaz to a beleaguered politician in flicks like Kitten with a Whip and Madam X. He enjoyed earlier TV success as a suave lawyer in Bachelor Father and a father to his real-life wife and children in the short-lived sitcom The John Forsythe Show. Some of his final roles included playing Charlie once again in the movies Charlie's Angels and Charlie's Angels Full Throttle. Forsythe was 92 when he died from cancer in 2010. Along with Jacqueline Smith, who played Angel Kelly Garrett, David Doyle starred in every Charlie's Angels episode. Doyle's affable yet bumbling aide, John Bosley, started as a comedic foil, but wound up being one of the show's most beloved characters, even nabbing an Emmy nomination in 1977. Charlie's Angels producer Leonard Goldberg told the Television Academy Foundation, "We thought that the character of Bosley should be your favorite uncle, the guy you were always pleased to see, who always made you smile, and who always made you feel good. And David Doyle just had those qualities about him." Doyle was prolific on screen and on stage, finding work on TV shows like Lois and Clark and All in the Family, and such movies as Capricorn One and Paper Lion. He put his gravelly voice to effect as a Catholic patriarch in the 1972 sitcom Bridget Loves Bernie, which centered on a romance between a Jewish cab driver and his affluent Catholic wife. Despite positive ratings, CBS canceled the show after several religious groups objected. Until his death in 1997 at age 67 of a heart attack, Doyle was still working, adding his voice to the animated series Rugrats as Grandpa Lou Pickles.
"I've been wrangling youngins since before you were born."
Tanya Roberts didn't create much of an impression during the final season of Charlie's Angels, as the newest actor to snare a role on a show rife with cast changes.
"That's the way every job is. I guess there was someone before you, there'll be somebody after you."
Nobody succeeded Roberts, however. The show was canceled in 1981, after she had only starred in 16 episodes. After the series, she enjoyed a more lucrative career starring in fantasy adventures like The Beastmaster and Sheena, Queen of the Jungle. In 1985, Roberts struck gold in the James Bond thriller A View to a Kill, but she wasn't able to take advantage of the hype for long, spending several years working in B-movies like Twisted Justice and Sins of Desire. Roberts made another another comeback in 1998 when she was cast on That 70s Show, playing mom Midge Pinciotti. She recalled to How I Got the Part, "I had hardly anything to do in the interview. It was just this couple of lines, but it worked out." She appeared in 5 seasons of the show, but left in 2001 to care for her ailing husband, fellow actor Barry Roberts, who died 5 years later. In 2021, Roberts died at age 65 from a urinary tract infection. One small footnote in the Charlie's Angels saga belongs to actor David Ogden Stiers, who appeared in the 1976 pilot as Scott Woodville, a subordinate of Charlie and John Bosley's boss. He inexplicably disappeared after that episode, leaving Bosley to manage affairs himself. A year later, Stiers signed on to join the cast of the TV adaptation of MASH, playing pompous surgeon Charles Winchester. While his character was an occasionally adversarial foil in the sitcom, other stars of the show recalled him fondly. Alan Alda tweeted after Stiers' death, "David Ogden Stiers, I remember how you skateboarded to work every day down busy LA streets. How, once you glided into stage 9, you were Winchester to your core. How gentle you were. How kind. Except when devising the most vicious practical jokes. We love you, David. Goodbye." After MASH, Stiers was never lacking for work, grabbing roles in such movies as Harry's War, TV shows like The Dead Zone and Stargate Atlantis, and voiceover work in projects that included Justice League and Lilo and Stitch. Stiers was still committed to gigs when he died of bladder cancer in 2018. He was 75. When the Angels went to solve cases in Hawaii, they could always count on Lieutenant Torres of the Oahu Police Department to help sleuth out crimes that included assaults, murder, kidnapping, and smuggling, some of them on picturesque beaches. Korean actor Soon-Tek Oh, who played the lawman, was equally in demand for other primetime dramas, having appeared in such shows as Hawaii Five-0, Kung Fu, Magnum P.I., MASH, and Touched by an Angel. The actor, who later in life provided the voice of wise elder Fa Zhu in the animated movies Mulan and Mulan 2, garnered additional exposure in several high-profile movies, including Beverly Hills Ninja, Missing in Action 2, and the James Bond flick, The Man with the Golden Gun. Oh told The Hollywood Reporter, "My agent asked me if I would like to be in a James Bond picture. I was a bit audacious when I was younger, so I said, I don't do a laundryman, gardener, or houseboy."
"Sorry, Commander. I had to get you away from the Hong Kong police, but didn't know how much you knew."
According to the New York Times, Oh hated portraying Asian stereotypes, though he had to accept some of those gigs anyway. Still, he found time to found organizations like Society of Heritage Performers and the East-West Players Theater Group to foster more acting opportunities for Asian-American actors. Oh was 85 when he died of Alzheimer's in 2018. We can't cover all the guest stars who appeared on Charlie's Angels, but Dick Sargent's roles on the show allowed him to flex his acting muscles. His appearances saw him play a casino entertainer connected to a string of murders, a roller derby team owner, and an insurance adjuster trying to recover stolen statues. Sargent was better known as the second Darren Stevens, husband to Elizabeth Montgomery's Samantha in the 60s sitcom Bewitched, succeeding original Darren, Dick York. He had numerous other guest spots on TV shows, including Three's Company, Taxi, and Fantasy Island. Long before LGBTQ identities were more mainstream, Sargent was also recognized for being a trailblazing advocate of gay rights, often working AIDS humanitarian initiatives when he came out as gay himself in 1991. He told Entertainment Tonight, "I don't have AIDS. I am HIV negative, but if I did, I would wear that badge as proudly as everybody else who has it." Sargent was 64 when he died of prostate cancer in 1994. Although actor Robert Reed will forever be remembered as Brady Bunch dad Mike Brady, he mostly acted in dramas. One of those more action-oriented experiences included a 2-part installment of Charlie's Angels, in which he played a homicidal nephew of a millionaire who believed one of the angels was his long-lost daughter. Such juicy fare was likely his way of moving on from the Brady Bunch, which Reed reportedly hated. He once told People, "To the degree that it serves as a babysitter, I'm glad glad we did it, but I do not want it on my tombstone.
I'd meant to be a classical actor. That's what I studied for.
Reed first got noticed in the 60s as a brash lawyer in The Defenders and in a recurring role in Dr. Kildare. He also played police officer Adam Tobias in the detective series Mannix, followed by roles in the groundbreaking series Rich Man, Poor Man, and the epic historical drama Roots. His contempt for the Brady Bunch didn't stop him from taking part in a few televised variety spin-offs and a short-lived 90s revival series called The Bradys. His death in 1992 from complications due to AIDS revealed another part of the actor's life that was most likely unknown by his fans. He was gay. He was only 59 when he died.